வணக்கம் ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் சோ லெட் மீ see the last unit of this chapter is chemistry that is carbon and its compounds unit 11 carbon and its compounds okay see in our lower classes we have seen lot of elements 118 elements we know that see what we are going to see in this unit carbon and its compound actually carbon is also one of the element it has to be combined with other element to form lot of compounds we are living with human life regarding that we are eating food having medicines or wherever we are using some compound is related with carbon why we need carbon why we are using carbon everywhere so what see these are all the things we are going to see in this chapter carbon and its compounds see first thing that is what are the properties of carbon so carbon means is a catenation means chain formation carbon has to be combined carbon has to be combined with some other elements to form chain open link or closed link so that is the catenation formation see already these are the terms these carbon and its compounds we have discussed in 9th standard also is the introduction part what are the terms we are learning in this carbon so these are all the terms we have already discussed in 9th standard but let me see how we have to make a carbon compounds and what is the see what are the products of should be formed by using the carbons and with other elements so first thing is catenation means carbon combines with other elements to form a compound so that is catenation tetravalency carbon has the valency that is 4 tetra means 4 so carbon valency is 4 that is also one of the property and multiple bonding means single bond double bond triple bond so carbon have multiple bonding is there multiple bonded with some other elements that is multiple bonding and combines with other element that means carbon has to combines with oxygen nitrogen sulfur hydrogen CH CO so like that the carbon has to combined with some other elements like hydrogen oxygen sulfur like that and the main thing of carbon is it has to make a covalent bonds means these carbon has to share their electrons when the carbon has to share that means the outermost shell if it is in the unpaired so it has to be paired with nearby atoms so that is covalent bond so carbon have the covalent bond it has to be shared electrons unpaired electrons to form a paired one and so these are the properties it should be considered as an organic compounds so carbon is an organic compounds because these organic compounds this carbon compounds has to be make it from naturally and also synthetic formation also we have to use green synthetic means use laboratory also we have to prepared a organic compounds like carbon and its compounds so general characteristics of organic compounds so what are the general characteristics of organic compounds let me see the first one if you are saying the carbon compounds that molecular weight is very high because this carbon has to form lot of compounds using some other elements so that the structure is also very different structure means that the complex structure is very difficult to understand and the next one that organic compounds it is insoluble in water insoluble means does not soluble in water and it has to be soluble in organic solvents that is ether carbon tetrachloride toluene so these are all the solvents which has to be soluble as the organic compounds Next thing is highly inflammable, that is it will be easily burned. So highly inflammable and less reactive. Less reactive means carbon is taking very long time to react when you compare with the inorganic compounds. Next thing, covalent bond. Already we have seen covalent bond means sharing of electrons. Okay, sharing of electrons. So carbon is very highly shared with the nearby atoms, that is covalent bond. Next characteristics is lower melting and boiling point. So melting and boiling point is very low. And isomerism, what is the meaning of isomerism? That means structural formula is always same. So molecular formula is always same, but if you are seeing that the properties, physical and chemical properties is different. So molecular formula same, physical and chemical properties are different. We called it as an isomerism. And volatile in nature, easily evaporated. Volatile nature means, volatile means easily evaporated. So easily evaporated in nature, all the organic compounds are easily evaporated. The last one, most of the compounds we are prepared in laboratory. So you lot of compounds we have to prepare from laboratory. And the next thing, classification of organic compounds. How you have to classify the organic compounds? Using the pattern of carbon chain. So carbon chain, later with the carbon chain, you have to classify the organic compounds. First thing, that is acyclic or open chain compound. Acyclic or open chain means that pattern, that chain pattern, carbon chain pattern is open type. That type of compound, how it will look, that is atoms are linked in a linear pattern. For example, here propane is there. It should be in the linear pattern. Second thing, single bonds are there. Not only single bond, double bond, triple bond is there, but if it is in single bond, then we call it as a saturator. If the compound have the double or triple bond means it is unsaturated. So double or triple bond means unsaturated. So acyclic or open chain means is a linear pattern of carbon chain. Okay. The next type of classification of organic compound is cyclic compound. So cyclic, how it is a closed type. So carbon chain should be in closed type. So only carbon atoms are there. If you are seeing only carbon atoms, where you see the example. And second thing, carbon has to combine with other atoms like oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur. If you are seeing that cyclic carbon, maybe the carbon compounds alone it is there. Otherwise, the carbon has to combine with some other elements. That is called heterocyclic compound. When only carbon atom it should be present, that is called carbocyclic compound. So carbocyclic, the carbocyclic means alicyclic and aromatic. So what is the meaning of alicyclic and aromatic? Alicyclic means one or two carbocyclic, if it is present, one or two carbocyclic rings it is present, means that is called alicyclic. That means saturated or unsaturated means single bond it is present, and unsaturated means double or triple bond. So one or more carbocyclic. What is the meaning of carbocyclic? Carbocyclic means only the carbon atoms should be present. Okay, and aromatic means it should be closed and one or more benzene rings are present. So benzene, it should be closed, but it should be in the benzene rings. And here alternate double bonds are there. Alternate means one is single single bond, another one is double, single double. So alternate double bonds are there. So these are all the types of carbocyclic acid. Let me see the example. See carbocyclic, I told, see that is the carbon chain only. See carbon is there. So that is alicyclic. If the benzene is it should be present, means that is heterocyclic. Alternate double bond is there. And heterocyclic means one of the examples are there, furan. So these are the examples of carbocyclic. Next topic, classes of organic compounds based on the kinds of atoms. See, here already we have discussed the classification of organic compounds based on the carbon chain. Here what we are going to see, that is kinds of atoms. Kinds of atom means number of carbon atoms. Okay, so number of carbon atoms, if we see, we know that carbon is combined with a lot of elements, oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, combining the lot of elements to form a lot of organic compounds. Let me see, the first or the most important organic compound is hydrocarbon. So hydrocarbon, from the word itself you have to know that hydrocarbon, hydrogen and oxygen combined with are combined to form lot of organic compounds. How we have to get these organic compounds? By using the three classes of hydrocarbon, that is alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. What is the meaning of alkanes? See, if any single bond, if it is presented in between two carbon atoms, any single bond, then we call it as an alkanes. If two bond, if it is present in between two carbon atoms, then it is called alkenes. Then triple bond, three bond, if it is present in between two carbon atoms, then it is called alkynes. Let me see the first classes of hydrocarbon, that is alkanes. See, the first characteristics of alkanes is that the carbon, in between carbon, there is a single bond. If that organic compound contains single bond means, that is saturated compound. How we have to represent the single bond in an organic compound? Let me see the first example, methane. See, carbon, hydrogen, we know that carbon consists of n valency 4. So one of the characteristics, that is tetravalency. So 4, so hydrogen it should be shared like this. If you are seeing, this is the structure of methane. If you are seeing in between carbon and hydrogen, there is only one bond, single bond is present. So we call it as a methane. This methane is under the classes alkanes. Okay. See, the next, the main part of these alkanes, that is the general formula. Using this general formula, we are getting lot of organic compounds by using this alkanes. Let me see the general formula, that is CnH2n+2. CnH2n+2. This is the formula to get lot of hydrocarbon compounds by using this alkane. See, N is, N represents number of carbon atoms. If the carbon atoms is increased, we are getting lot of organic compounds. Let me see how we are getting that organic compounds by using this general formula. See, CnH2n+2. This is the general formula. If we have only one carbon atom, C, n equal to 1, and H, 2 × 1 + 2. C, 1, H, 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, C, H, 4. This is the first product of alkanes, that is methane, C, H, 4. Like that, you have to substitute carbon 2, C2, H2 into 2. Like that, if you are substituting or if you are increasing the number of carbon atoms, we are getting lot of product. So, this is the first classes of hydrocarbon, and in this hydrocarbon, these classes, alkanes, we are getting lot of product. Likewise, the second classes is alkenes. See, alkenes means the first characteristic of alkenes, that is two bond, that means double bond has to be present in the carbon to carbon. So double bond. If double bond is present in an organic compound, definitely that organic compound is an unsaturated compound. We know that. And what is the general formula to get that organic compound from these alkenes, that is CnH2n. So, N already we know number of carbon atoms. So, the number of carbon atoms, if it is increased, we are getting lot of product. Let me see the first example, CnH2n. If N equal to 1, number of carbon atom is 1, C1H2 × 1. So, CH2. So CH2 is not possible is any product if it is not get from alkenes. So this N is equal to 1 is not suited in alkenes and alkynes. Okay, N is only suitable for alkanes. There is no product from CH2. So obviously we will start from N is equal to 2. So C2H2 into 2. What is that? C2H4. C2H4 is the first product we have to get from alkenes, that is ethylene. That is ethylene. If you are seeing that last three letters from the product, that is ENE. This ENE represent alkenes. So like that, each and every part, ethylene, propylene, butylene, so E. And from the word itself, you have to know that that product will get from alkenes. So in that product, there is a double bond, its double bond is present, is unsaturated compound. So like that, you have to understand each and every organic compound, how it has to derive from the general formula, how we have to give the name of that organic compound. Let me see that next topic. Finally, you have to get the idea of how you have to calculate the organic compound from these three classes. Let me see the last hydrocarbon. So next topic, alkynes. Alkynes means the triple bond is present in between the carbon atoms. If that organic compound contains triple bond, means triple bond, it is an unsaturated compound. Lot of organic compound gets from these alkynes. By using the general formula CnH2n-2. So here the N represents the number of carbon atoms. Alkenes alone, the number of carbon atoms is 1. Other than that, alkenes and alkynes starts from the number of carbon atoms is 2. Let me see what is the product has to be get from that number of atoms is 2. See, N is equal to 2, C2H 2 into 2 minus 2. So C2H4 minus 2, that is H2. So C2H2, that is the product name is ethyne. So ethyne means the last three letters of each and every product gets from alkynes, that is I-Y-N-E, ethyne. Then propyne, butyne, pentyne. So like that, each and every product gets from that alkynes, that is alkyne, like that propane, butane, like that we have to get lot of organic compounds. So what is the difference between these three alkanes, alkenes and alkynes, that is the bond and also number of carbon atoms and also the product. So we know that these are the hydrocarbons, these are the classes where we have lot of hydrocarbon product also formed. You see, what are the common characteristics of all these hydrocarbons? Let me see the next topic. That is, all the hydrocarbons has to be in most in gaseous state. Gaseous state is propane gas, ethane gas, methane gas, so all are in gaseous state. Then definitely that all the hydrocarbons are odorless, there is no smell and colorless. And if the carbon atoms is increases, then the boiling point is also increases. If the carbon atom is increases, boiling point also increases. Then hydrocarbon, there is definitely a combustion reaction is taken place. Carbon react with oxygen, we get carbon dioxide, so plus water. Then alkanes is the least reactive compared with other hydrocarbons, because there is a single bond only, it should be present in that compound. So that is the least reactive. But alkynes is the most reactive because it contains three bonds. So it is very difficult to break down these three bonds. So alkynes is the most reactive. Then alkanes, we know that that is a saturated compound. Then alkynes and alkenes is an unsaturated compound, because alkanes only single bond is present, alkynes and alkenes two and three bond is present, so we call it as an unsaturated. Then all the hydrocarbon compounds, it is insoluble in water. So where it is soluble? that is called some carbon tetra or organic solvents. We call it as an organic solvents. That solvents called as ester, carbon tetrachloride. So some of the fluids are there or solvents are there, and that solvent only the hydrocarbon is soluble. Then next topic is test to identify saturated and unsaturated compound. See, we have discussed lot of saturated and unsaturated compound. We know that, but how we have to identify whether the compound is saturated or unsaturated? See, you take a sample solution in a test tube and pour or add few drops of bromine water. Bromine. So bromine liquid, if you add a few drops, means that liquid will show some changes. Let me see what changes should be happen. See, saturated. If that liquid is saturated, means that the bromine will decolorize or colorize. Do not decolorize. So if that bromine water is brown in color, means if you add that bromine water into that solution, it will shows the same brown color. Do not decolorize, means that is saturated. So that what you have to understand, in that the solution contain alkanes is present. That means a single bond compound should be present in the solution. So alkanes oriented organic compound is present in that solution. So do not decolorize the bromine water, means that is saturated. If that solution is decolorized the bromine water, that is unsaturated. So what you conclude that from in that solution, sometimes it is an alkynes or alkenes should be present in the solution. So these are the basic classification of carbons and hydrocarbons. Thank you, students.